Alrighty, well, praise the Lord Jesus Christ, guys. We're back at it again with an interesting topic today. It's going to be called The Patience of the Saints or Tribulation Believers. So it's going to be very interesting. I pray you catch some revelation. I pray that those that sincerely love Christ will be blessed by this word. I want to make a couple recommendations before we start. First and foremost, I recommend you get your Bible. You know what I'm saying? Make sure you have your word on you. And follow along in the scriptures. Read along and write some of the scriptures down to help your walk and to help you with this subject, because this is a very debated subject. Are Christians going to go through the tribulation? Okay? It's a very interesting subject. So I pray some of the scriptures are helpful and your understanding on the topic. But before we get started, I want to give a quick shout out to a very strong ministry that has blessed my life tremendously. Revelations of Jesus Christ Ministries. I highly recommend all you that love Jesus Christ, that truly love him, and know what's going on in the world and exposing the evil, exposing the enemy's devices, I believe you will truly be blessed by this ministry. So go ahead and subscribe, connect, check out the videos. Very powerful ministry. This is the ministry that the Lord Jesus Christ used to turn me around completely from darkness to light. So I've been so blessed by the ministry. Of course, yes, you see on the screen here, there's films, there's parables, all type of good messages. But one thing that I think will really bless you is the dinner table messages, okay? They exalt Jesus Christ. They help you really understand the scriptures much more. And of course, the word is going to be brought forth. So there's going to be a lot of scripture, okay? So you want teachings that are Bible-based. And nowadays, it seems to be hard to find true men and women of God really teaching the word. You know, they're out there, but they're few in between. So I highly recommend checking out Revelations of Jesus Christ, subscribing. Some of you guys have probably found my channel from Revelations of Jesus Christ Ministries. And one more channel I want to recommend, my brother Elvis. Okay, his channel is called Christ Jesus is the Truth. And Lord willing, I can put a link below in the description box for the channels. He's a very blessed teacher. He's a growing leader. And he's anointed by the Lord to teach the word of God. And so I highly recommend if you're in a situation where you feel alone, you feel like you're in the wilderness, but you might live in a city. You might live around a lot of people, but you feel like you're all alone regarding your outlook on life, regarding your relationship with Christ, regarding your beliefs, regarding, you know, just feeling outcasted by the world. Just know Jesus Christ, you know, felt the same way. He was despised and rejected by the world. But I want to recommend a video. It's right here. Look on the screen. Brother Elvis made this video called The Wilderness. And it's a very blessed video. I think it'll really speak to you and encourage you and encourage your spirit, man, to keep pressing forward. Okay? So hang in there, guys. Endure to the end. And let's get into today's word. So we got to define the words here in this channel. You know, you guys know how it is. So what does the word patience mean? If we're talking about the patience of the saints, well, let's define it in English. And you know, a little bit later on, we're going to get into the Greek word as well. You know, we got to trace it back a little bit. Let's define the word patience before we read the scriptures regarding patience. Patience means a calm temper which bears evil without murmuring or discontent. The act or quality of waiting long for justice or expected good without discontent. Perseverance, right? Perseverance. Perseverance can also mean endurance, okay? And we'll get into that shortly. So someone could be in a situation and they feel like they can say, well, I know patience. I know what it's like to wait a really long time for something. Well, what is the attitude and the mind that you have while you're waiting? Because that is what patience is. Having the right, excuse me one second, it's having the right attitude, the right mind during those trials, the right mind state. Okay? So let's get into what the Word of God says. We're going to talk about tribulation believers today. It's a heavily debated topic. So I hope the scriptures can really edify you. Romans 5, verse 2 to 4. Hold on, guys. So I'm really in this uncomfortable in this position. All right, that's a little better. I see y'all can see me a little better. I see y'all a little better. You know, I think I see you up in there.
You in there?
Oh, you in there. All right. And, all right, guys. Romans 5, verse 2 to 4. By whom also we have by faith entered the grace wherein we stand and rejoice in the hope of the glory of God. And not only so, but we glory in tribulations also, knowing that tribulation worketh patience, and patience experience, and experience hope. Wait a minute. Patience, or should I say tribulation, produces patience? Tribulation helps make one of the fruits of the Spirit? Helps produce that in you. Tribulation. Interesting. What does it say here in Revelation 14, verse 12? Here is the patience of the saints. Here are they that keep the commandments of God and the faith of Jesus. Hold on. That's Revelation 14. That's more than halfway through the book of Revelation, and the saints are still mentioned. Here's the patience of the saints. Wait, well, let's read the above verses. Let's see why they're mentioned. Okay. Third angel followed them, saying with a loud voice, if any man worship the beast and his image and receive his mark in his forehead or in his hand, the same shall drink of the wrath of God. Hold on. So this angel is preaching, saying whoever takes the mark of the beast is going to taste the wrath of God and go to the lake of fire. And in the next verses, here is the patience of the saints. That means the saints are going to be here for the mark of the beast. They're still being written about. That's why it talks about the mark of the beast. It talks about the punishment of all those that take it. And here is the patience of the saints. They're still here. Okay, and here is the patience of the saints. What does it say right here? But we glory in tribulations, knowing that tribulation works patience. Look at that. And then we're reading about tribulation right here. And we see the saints are here. Okay, they're still here. Revelation 14. Okay, Revelation 13, chapter before 14, obviously, right? Is what's that about? It's all about the mark of the beast, and all these things going on. It's about the dragon. It's all. Go ahead, read it for yourself. I highly recommend it. But what does it say at the bottom? Right, read the screen. Verse 10. He that leadeth into captivity shall go into captivity. He that kills with the sword must be killed by the sword. Here is the patience of this and the faith of the saints. Here's the patience and the faith of the saints. Hold on, what did we read before? Oh, we read right here about the faith. By whom also we have access by faith into this grace wherein we stand and rejoice in the hope of the glory of God. And not only so, but we glory in tribulations, knowing that tribulation worketh patience. So again, boom. The saints are going through this again. They're going through this period of time. Right? He that leads into captivity shall go into captivity. He that kills with a sword must be killed by the sword. Some people say that's war. There's many interpretations on what that scripture represents. But regardless of what you think it represents, here's the patience of the saints and the faith of the saints. They're still here. So they're there in chapter 12, 13, and 14. Saints are still here. Producing them fruits of the Spirit, man. Got to produce fruit. All right. What does the Bible say? You shall know them by their fruits. What produces patience? Tribulation. The Lord wants us to have fruit. Revelation 12, 17. The dragon was wroth with the woman and went to make war with the remnant of her seed, which keep the commandments of God and have the testimony of Jesus Christ. Clearly, if they have the testimony of Jesus Christ and they keep the commandments, they are believers. 1 John 5, 3, what? That's how you know who believes in God. Him who loves God keeps his commandments, right? And what does it say? And they have a testimony of Jesus Christ. Clearly, these are Christians. So now we're in chapter 12, Revelation. Revelation 12, 13, and 14. Boom. Saints are still here. And look, they're going to war. It says that this dragon wants to make war with the remnant of her seed. These are they which keep the commandments of God. So let's see something real quick. Let's look in Greek. What does patience mean in the Greek? All right. Patience in the Greek means, look at the screen, it means endurance. to endure. Ah, endurance, to endure. Hmm. What does that sound like? Here's the patience of the saints. Here's the endurance of the saints. Because remember, we just looked up the word patience in Greek. So if you're going to read it literal in the Greek, it would read, here is the endurance and the faith of the saints. See, they have to endure this. Okay? But don't worry. There's hope. There's hope. You know what I'm saying? It's not. You know what I'm saying? Hey, it's just the reality of the situation. The saints are going to have to endure. So you can swap out the word patience with endurance. They go hand in hand. And look at this. James 1:12. Now watch this. This is where it gets kind of interesting. James 1:12. Blessed is the man that endureth temptation. For when he is tried, he shall receive the crown of life, which the Lord has promised to them that love him. Well, we just see those that love him are those that keep his commandments. And he promised this crown to them if they can endure temptation and be tried. So they're going to have to be tried. They have to endure temptation and be tried, right? And then what? That he shall receive the crown of life, which the Lord has promised. So you want to get, if you make it to heaven, right, you want to go there with crowns laid at Jesus Christ's feet. And how do you get one of those crowns? Well, you got to endure temptation. Okay, let's see if Revelation talks about that at all. Now watch the wording here. Revelation 3, chapter 3, verse 10 to 11. Because thou hast kept the word of my patience, or endurance, because thou hast kept the word of my patience, endurance, I also will keep thee from the hour of temptation, which shall come upon all the world to try them that dwell upon the earth. Behold, I come quickly. Hold that fast which thou hast. Let no man take thy crown. Wait, let no man take thy crown. How do you get the crown? Precept upon precept. You got to endure temptation. And what does it say? For when he is tried, he shall receive a crown of life. This temptation right here in the book of Revelation chapter 3. I will also keep thee from the hour of temptation, which will come upon all the world to do what? To try them that dwell upon the earth. Behold, I come quickly, hold fast, and no man takes thy crown. Listen, you're gonna have to endure this. You have to endure this temptation. Now, interesting note on the word temptation there. Hold on, where do I want to go with that? I'll go there. Okay, Lord. Look at this real quick. Look what the word temptation means. An experiment. An experiment. A trial. I will also keep you from the hour of the experiment, which will come upon all the earth, upon all the world, to try them as well on earth. Does anyone know what they're experimenting with right now? Look at the camera. Anyone know something where they're sticking it in people? It's the experiment on the human race. You should know what I'm talking about by now. It's a great experiment. It's going to try all those. It's going to try people to see, hey, these people love the job more than they love Jesus? Do these people love to be able to travel across seas more than they love Jesus? Because the experiment is going to try all those who dwell on earth. It's going to try their hearts. It's going to see what they're really made of. It's going to separate the wheat and the tares. Do they follow the crowd? Do they trust the man? The Bible says, curses the man that trusts the man and makes his arm flesh, whose heart departs from the Lord. It's going to try him. It's going to see who they trust him. Right? But he said, I'll keep you in that hour. I'll keep you from that hour. So when he says, I'll keep you from it, doesn't mean you're not going to go through it. Right? Because we see that in Revelation 12, 13, and 14, which is many chapters later, the saints are still here. So he says, I'll keep you. I just said how Paul said, Paul says, I was delivered. After Paul got stoned, and they thought he died, he said, the Lord delivered me. Did he deliver him from being stoned? No, he got stoned, but he delivered him. He let him live another day. He got him out of that situation. You see what I'm saying? He was with him. He delivered him, you know? But he had to suffer through it. He had to go through it. And we'll get into that in a second. So the experiment. Okay. The word temptation means experiment. Now watch this. Temptation means experiment. Experiment. All right, read this real quick, please, with me. Luke 8, verse 13. This is the parable about the seed. The seed, which is the word of God. Okay? Verse 13. Talk about the seed when they're planted, when it's planted in the rock. Okay. They are on the rock. They are on the rock, are they? Which when they hear, receive the word with joy, and these have no root. Which for a while believe, in a time of temptation, fall away. Did y'all catch that? In a time of the experiment, they fall away. You ever heard of the great falling away? 2 Thessalonians, look at it. It's a prophetic message. The Lord warning people. 2 Thessalonians 2:3. Let no man deceive you, for that day shall not come, except there come a falling away first, that man of sin be revealed, the son of perdition. Look how this is worded right here. They have no root, which for a while believe, in the time of temptation, fall away. So when this great experiment, this temptation comes upon the earth, and people put this inside their body, it's an experimental thing. They fall away. Now watch this. Watch this. Look at the word for falling away in the Greek there, in that verse. That there'll be a great falling away that happens first. It's the Greek word apostasia. Apostasia. And what does it mean? Apostasia means a falling away. Apostasy. So you say, well, but that doesn't really define what it means. What is it? What's apostasy? Well, I typed it into the English dictionary. Little Webster action. Okay. See what apostasy means. Because remember, this temptation, before we read the definition, leads to the falling away. In the time of temptation, fell away. Let no man deceive you. What? There'll be a great falling away first. So what is this falling away? Well, let's look at the word apostasy, which is the word for falling away. Apostasy. An abandonment of what one has professed. A total desertion. A departure from one's faith or religion. Look at meaning number three. The various solution of disease. Hold on. Let's read this in reverse order. The various solution of disease, the thing that's going in people's body right now, the various solution of disease led to the abandonment of what one has professed, a total desertion or departure of one's faith because it took the mark of the beast. They fell for their great temptation. The time of temptation, they fell away. And they left their faith because they trusted a man, not in God. They stuck out their own arm for the very solution of disease. They put the name of Lucifer in their body, and they were left desolate. Abomination of desolation. So look how that prophetically lines up together with Luke talking about in the time of temptation, they fell away. In the time of the experiment, they fell away. Because why did they fall away? Because it took the mark. And there'll be a great falling away first. There'll be a great experiment first. There'll be a great what? A solution for a disease. An abandonment. A total desertion of one's faith. That will happen first. Well, we see that happening right now all across the world. Okay. So I just found that quite interesting when I first heard it and found it. But that's what's happening right now. So let's finish off with some more scriptures, though. Let's go back to that. That was just a little side nugget, you know? Let's go back to tribulation believers, okay? Are believers going to be here for tribulation? Well, we just seen, recap, chapter 3, they're mentioned. Chapter 12, chapter 13, chapter 14, Revelation, the believers are still mentioned. So obviously, they're saints of God here. In order to be a saint of God, the people have to go through the process of sanctification. So it's not just some random people that got saved after tribulation. No, these people are going through it. They're having to resist the mark of the beast. Clearly. see what 2 Timothy says. Look at Paul. I just bring this up because it's that scripture, because where it says, I'll keep you from the hour of temptation, it reminds me of the language that Paul used. Now watch that language that Paul used. 2 Timothy 3:11 to 12. Persecutions, afflictions, which came unto me at Antioch and Iconium and Lystra, what persecutions I endured, but out of them all the Lord delivered me. Yea, and all that will live godly in Christ Jesus shall suffer persecution. So all that will live godly will have to suffer persecution. But hold on. He just said what happened to him in Antioch and Iconium, and the persecutions that he went through there, the Lord delivered him out of them all. So did the Lord just rip him away and he didn't have to go through nothing? What did he mean by the Lord delivered me? Well, let's read about what happened there in Acts. Acts chapter 14, verse 19 to 22. And there came thither certain Jews from Antioch and Iconium, who persuaded the people, and having stoned Paul, drew him out of the city, supposing he had been dead. They stoned him so bad, they thought he was dead. His body was probably not even moving. They drug him out of the city. They stoned people to death. That's how bad he went through it. But Paul's saying the Lord delivered him. He delivered him to live another day. He delivered him, you know what I'm saying? He came back. He got back up. But he had to go through it. So people say, oh, God's going to keep us from the hour of temptation. He's going to keep you under his wings during that hour. You're going to have to go through it, though. Look at Paul. Verse 20. Howbeit, as the disciples stood around about him, he rose up and came into the city. And the next day he departed with Barnabas and Derbe. And when they had preached the gospel to that city, had taught many, they returned again to Lystra and Iconium and Antioch. Listen to what happened. Confirming the souls of the disciples, let them know, yo, hey, you guys listening, all you disciples. Now, he didn't say yo, but hey, you disciples listening. Watch what he tells them. And exhorting them to continue in the faith, hang in there, stand strong, and that we must, through much tribulation, enter into the kingdom of God. Ooh, what did he say? Confirming the souls of the disciples, letting them know, exhorting them to continue in the faith, and that we must, through much tribulation, enter into the kingdom of God. So hold on. Paul's saying he was stoned. He said, Lord, deliver them. But deliver them to live another day. And he produced, and then what happens? Tribulation produces what? Patience. So Paul is going through these things, right? And he's literally becoming more solid in Christ. He's producing more and more fruit of the Spirit because tribulation produces patience, right? Long suffering, another fruit of the Spirit. And Paul let him know through much tribulation, people gotta go through much tribulation to enter into the kingdom of God. It sounds like the movie Pilgrim's Progress. If you haven't seen Pilgrim's Progress, please watch it. It's a very blessed movie. Through much tribulation to enter the kingdom of God. So they're going to go through tribulation. Matter of fact, you might have to go through much tribulation. 2 Thessalonians. Oh, what's this? Okay, what's this, Paul? Chapter 1, verse 4 to 10. So that we ourselves glory in you and the churches of God for your patience and faith in all your persecutions and tribulations that you endure. Now, look what happens though. Don't worry. You're gonna have to go through some stuff. Lord will keep you, but just know, what does it say? Vengeance is mine, says the Lord. He's coming for all the ungodly too. Don't think that just because believers are gonna have to go through stuff, the ungodly are gonna get away with it. Let's read this through real quick, okay? Let me rewind it. So that we ourselves glory in you and the churches of God for your patience and faith. And all your persecutions and tribulations that you endure, which is a manifest token of the righteous judgment of God, that you be counted worthy of the kingdom of God, for which you also suffer. Hold on. What did he just say earlier? Hold on. Pause. Can you catch that? through much tribulation, that we must through much tribulation enter in the kingdom of God. So why are you going through this? This is gonna see what you, and it's gonna see if you are wheat or if you're tares. Which is a manifest token of the righteous judgment of God, that you may be counted worthy of the kingdom of God, for which you also suffer. That's why you're suffering. So you can make it in. See, it's a righteous thing with God to recompense tribulation to them that trouble you. All right, here comes their repayment. Listen, they're going to have to go through tribulation too. But look what happens to them. The ungodly that are not right with Christ. Look what's going to happen to them. If you as a believer have to go through some tribulation, let's see what happens with these people. Verse 7. And to you who are troubled, rest with us when the Lord Jesus shall be revealed from heaven with his mighty angels and a flaming fire, taking vengeance on them that know not God and that obey not the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, who shall be punished with what? With this tribulation? Nah. Who shall be punished with everlasting destruction from the presence of the Lord and from the glory of his power, when he shall come to be glorified in his saints and to be admired in all them that believe, because our testimony among you was believed in that day. So he's going to be glorified in his saints. He produced the fruit in them. They went through things. They carried their cross. Jesus said, what? Pick up your cross and follow me. That's not easy. That means people want to die. They were going to die. They're going to die for him. They're going to go through some suffering. Partaking in the sufferings of Christ. That's what real believers are going to have to go through. 1 Corinthians 13:7 talks about love, all the things that love does. We know God is love, right? And we know that we're supposed to be filled with the love of God. Verse 13:7, love what? It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things. There's that word again, endures all things. Patience, endurance. Gotta go through it. Long suffering, gotta go through it. One more verse. Alrighty. Matthew 24:13. What does patience mean again? Endurance. What does it say in Matthew 24 about the end days? Matthew 24 is all about the end days. What would be the odds that Matthew 24, all about the end days, says this? This is Jesus talking. But he that shall endure to the end, the same shall be saved. So Jesus talks about it. We're writing about the end days in Matthew 24. Jesus talks about it in 2 Timothy 3. Paul talks about it in 2 Timothy 3, which is all about the end days as well. Tells you exactly what the end days are going to be like. And Paul is saying, listen, all that will live godly in Christ Jesus shall suffer persecution, right? We saw that in 2 Thessalonians, right? Or it was 1 Thessalonians. Let me see real quick. 1 Thessalonians talks about, let's get to it. Come on now. Where we at here? 2 Thessalonians talks about the falling away, but we know that the believers are going to be here for the falling away, correct? Y'all just saw that because it says there is a patience of the saints. Oh, here it is. It's 2 Thessalonians chapter 1. So one chapter before it's speaking about the Antichrist, 2 Thessalonians chapter 2, right? But a few verses before that, he's saying right here, so that we ourselves glory in you in the churches of God for your patience and faith and all your persecution and tribulation that you endure. What would be the odds of that? Talking about the Antichrist a few verses later, and you having to endure persecution and tribulation. Matthew 24, about the end days. He that endures to the end shall be saved. 2 Timothy, all about the end days. Talking about tribulation again. Revelation 12, 13, and 14. Here's the patience of the saints and what they have to go through. And chapter 3, they have to go through the hour of temptation. That's why I said, don't lose your crown. And how did a person get a crown? They got to go through that temptation to produce a patience and get that crown of patience, the crown of life. So anyhow, guys, I pray you're blessed by this message. I hope I wasn't too all over the place. I try to tie it in together. you know, there it is. Let me read it correctly. You know what I'm saying? James 1:12. Blessed is a man that endures temptation, for when he is tried, he shall receive the crown of life, which the Lord has promised them that believe him, that believe and love him. So there it is, guys. Because thou hast kept the word of my patience, I will also keep thee from the hour of temptation, which shall come upon all the world to try them that dwell upon the earth. Behold, I come quickly. Hold fast, which thou hast. Let no man take thy crown. Hold on. Remember that verse. To try them that are upon the earth. Watch this verse right here. Mm-mm-mm. That's not it. It's in Proverbs. Hold on. Come on now. Okay, what's it say? That temptation's going to come for what? To try them upon the earth. Read this verse about the Lord real quick. Proverbs 17:3. We'll close with this. The fining pot is for silver, and the furnace for gold, but the Lord trieth the hearts. So it's our temptation, whether or not someone's going to take the mark of the beast, it's going to try their heart. Are they wheat? Are they tares? Do they love Jesus Christ, or do they love the world? Do they love the commandments of God, or do they love to follow the commandments of the beast? There it is. Their heart's going to be tried. And I pray all those being tested make the right decision. So they're going to go through the fire. Look at this right here. The fining pot is for silver and the furnace for gold. But the Lord tried the heart. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, they got delivered. But did they get snatched away in that moment? They had to go through the fire. And the Lord showed up. He was with them in the fire. He's with Paul. He's with Paul. When Paul was shipwrecked, he's with him. Stephen got stoned to death, had the face of an angel. The Lord with him. The Lord was with him the whole time. They had to go through the fire. Now, don't get me wrong. We believe in a snatching away. But it's clear as day that believers are going to have to endure some things in the book of Revelation. They're going to have to be here for some time. So hang in there. I have some more nuggets at some point. Maybe I can share with you guys about when that time may be regarding snatching away. But I haven't got full confirmation from the Lord. And if I have, I'm seeking the Lord about it. I'm like, Lord, is that? I don't want to preach something that ain't fully tried. You know what I'm saying? I got to make sure it's legit. But let's just say I'm meditating on some interesting things. Godly meditation. I'm talking about meditating on the scripture. Not no weird chance. Not no weird, like, you know, pagan chance. The only chance we do out here is holy chance. Holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty. That's the kind of chance that we do out here in the name of Jesus Christ. So we love y'all. Salute. And until next time, hey, we'll talk.